Hello and welcome to Hadoop Exam Learning Resources. Now we are going to start SAS Advanced Certification Training. The certification number is A00232. This is an advanced certification, which is like if you have already cleared like A00215 and A00231 certification, then this training you can use it for your advanced learning in SAS. Correct. So SAS has like in this advanced module, three major parts they have to cover is SQL, macro processing, arrays, and some advanced technique and utility you need to know. So we would be covering the entire solution in this training, like all the topics we would be covering in this training, and we would be focusing concept as well as example. So more than 100 or 150 we would be covering example throughout this training. So entire syllabus would be covered around 15, 16 or 17 modules. So we have yet to record remaining modules, so I don't know exact count, but that would go, and each module would be having more section as well. Correct. So our focus would be on purely hands-on as well as concept-based learning. So you need to know every concept. So once you complete this training, you should be capable of writing A00232 exam as well. However, to practice for A00232 exam, Hadoop exam is providing separate certification preparation material, which is like you can go on the HadoopExam.com. Like let me show you here. Go to the SAS. So here all our SAS product is listed here. So we have all this module. So currently we have A00232 with 20 scenarios plus around 100 or 150 multiple choice question we are going to add today as well in this certification. So you will get those multiple choice question and answer as well. Other SAS certification preparation material also you can find it over here. And we also have launched the 165 interview question and answer for SAS base. So we would be adding such interview questions and etc. So you can always refer this page for your SAS related stuff to you wanted to know. So now I would be covering like in the first module is SQL. Okay, so this is like SQL module itself is we have divided into six different modules. Okay, so I would be covering with the introduction concepts, some examples, and then we move further to cover more complex stuff. Okay, so let's start with this. Okay, so this is the PDF which I would be sharing with you as well, so you can download it and you can use it. Okay, so about SQL. SQL is not a new thing or something which is coming from the SAS. If you already have learned the RDBMS in your college background, if you are fresher and if you are already working in the industry, so I'm sure you might have heard SQL. This is structured query language. This is one of the most easiest way to fetch the data and to work with the data which is stored in the RDBMS system. That's the reason SAS also has to develop this module, because they are also want people who already know the SQL can work with the SAS as well. So if you are using SAS data set previously and now you wanted to move to SQL, okay, so data step I mean, so then, and if you are comfortable with the SQL, so I think this is much easier than data step using the SQL step, because SQL query is very rich actually, and many things you can do this with the SQL. So we would learn the stuff one by one, and we'll compare as well data set and SQL query. Okay, so SQL is widely used in RDBMS and NoSQL database. Now onwards you would also use this with the SAS. Okay, and this is one of the most important topic for the SAS A00232 certification as well. So things which you can do with the SAS data set, data step, you can also do with the Proc SQL. So this is again a procedure actually. So as structured query language support is provided by one procedure, okay, in the SAS. So how does actually the things you need to understand are the same stuff like which you were working with the data set, correct? Observation, columns, features, etc. Correct? Same thing over here. Here the data set is referred as a table in case of Proc SQL, or you can say view. So we'll see further actually what is view and kind of thing. This is advanced concept, okay. And here you can see this is in the picture I have shown you one table, correct? So this we say in SQL world we will say table. In the SAS data step world we would say it is a data set, okay. So how many observation you can see here is there are four observation, because four rows are there. So in SQL world we would say it is a row. So there are four rows here. Variables, there are six variables. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this is also known as columns in the SQL world. So just slight terminology difference, but very intuitive to understand. It's not like it's something different. So there is a column and row in the table, that's all you have to for the SQL perspective. So same thing in the data step, we say data set, we say observation. So four observation equal to four rows, six variable equal to six columns. So what you can do with this table actually is whatever, if you have done with this data step, same thing you can do. You can fetch the data from the existing table. So if you already have a table, correct? So this is the example which I have shown here. This is my table here. How many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 columns are there. I can select data out of this, and I can even select only specific column as well. So in this here, you can see I want to fetch only three column: ID, name, and fee. So I can fetch only these first three column if I want it. Okay, I can specify which or column I need it. Even I can update the existing data in the table using either insert, update, delete, whatever operation I wanted to do, I can do on this table as well. Even you can add new column, let's say here 5 columns, correct? If I wanted to add one more column in the same table, I can do that very easily, okay? With this, just writing some query and we can do this, okay? You can create a new table from existing table as well, okay? So let me show you over here. Suppose you have this table, this which has 3 column right now. If you want to add additional column to this table, you can do this. Just like how I would be showing you in the future session how we can do this. So 3 column table can be updated with 4 column table. So that is doable. Okay. So now, okay, so let me go through one example actually. Okay, let's first go through over here. So how my query works, okay? So you would be writing Proc SQL first, and always your Proc SQL end with the quit statement, okay? Not with the run statement. Remember, always end with the quit statement. Now, what is my table name over here? Let's say my table name is a course, okay? So what I wanted to write in select query, select some column name, okay, from, and table name, okay? You have to provide here, after from clause you would be providing the table name, and where is the condition. If you don't want to extract everything from this table, then provide some condition, like I want only this record rows which satisfy this condition. So what condition here is, fee is greater than 500, okay? So now see, ID, name, and fee, this three column I needed. So ID, name, and fee, this three column would be selected, okay, from this course table. The name of the table is course here, and where condition fee. Now let's see, fee is greater than 500, so only this record marked in green satisfies this condition, so they would be returned as an output. So you can see only three column would be returned over here, and only rows which satisfy this condition. Now in the where clause, it is not necessary, like you provide condition based on the column which you are selecting, correct? Suppose you are selecting some this three column, and if you want to put condition on the website column, then also you can put the condition. It is not necessary, like your condition should have the same column which is you are selecting. You can have a condition on the column which you are not going to select as well, okay? So let me go ahead with the example. So this is my PDF actually, which I would be sharing, which contains all the example over here. So let's start with the one of the examples. So these are all SAS product currently we are providing. So I would recommend, please refer our website to get the latest, okay, always. So now let me copy this code here and go to SAS Studio. You might have already installed SAS Studio from my previous session where we have learned, okay? So let me paste over here and format the code over here. So I would be providing this data as well, okay? So you need to put this data on this folder. How do you put this folder? You should know actually. So you might have checked on our previous session how to keep the data. So what I want, this hedata1.csv file, I wanted to convert this file into table first and then select the data out of this. So what we would be using, file name we would be using to create the file reference. So here hedata is what, file reference. So it is pointing to this file, okay? So what exactly the file reference? So your file is somewhere on the disk, correct? This is your file somewhere on the disk, okay? This is your disk on this file as well. So this is somewhere C colon common abc.txt, correct? So you won't write in the SAS program again and again this entire path. This is not a good idea. What you would be doing, one file pointer would be creating. So that is known as file reference in the SAS. So we'll, let's say hedata module1.csv is my name to this file. Okay, so here we are pointing this file, okay, this file on the disk as a HE data, okay, HE data as a reference file. So now in my entire program, I would use this HE data file reference, okay. So now I wanted to create a temporary data set out of this. So whatever you put into the work library would be your temporary data set. So what is the my data set name would be work.hedata1. How would you create using the import statement? We would be importing this file. Okay, the file pointer we are using it here, which indirectly points to this path. Okay, and we are saying the format of my file is CSV. So load CSV is comma separated file. And we are using replace because I have been running this statement again and again, again and again. So I wanted it to be replaced kind of thing without giving any error. You can avoid using this replace if you don't want to create again. Okay. So here this is the how you put the comment is here. Put the star and okay, this one. And then semicolon at the end. And whatever you write in between would be considered as a comment and would not be executed. Okay. So now here I would show you, this is the table which I have created, HE data 1. Okay. Now from this table, HE data 1, I wanted to select specific column. Okay. So let me first show you what all column this has. Okay. So this is the first session. That's the reason I'm going in detail. Actually, people might not know everything. So I have to go through in detail. Okay. So simply putting the star would select all the column from this table. Okay. So let me run this part only. Okay, so that's what show you. So my table would have 5 columns: ID, course name, fee, location, and date. Okay, this 5 columns this table has, and 10 rows. Okay, 10 rows you can see here. Okay, so in the dataset out report you have seen there is an observation is always printed over here. Correct, until unless you suppress it. But in case of SQL report, there is no row number would be printed, and you have to specifically provide the some option to print the row number. So ID is an actual value coming from your data. Okay, so that's the thing. Okay, so let me show you here. Okay, so this is how my file looks like. Correct, here you can see this is the ID column, course name, course fee, location, and date. So all columns have been selected and all 10 rows have been selected, and it is visible over here in the SAS output as we can see over here. Correct. Now from this table I wanted to select only specific column, let's say ID, course name, course fee, location. Now I wanted to give different name to the location. Okay, so what I would be using here as operator here. Okay, you can see here, and what exactly this known as alias. Okay, alias. So what I wanted to give this column name as when my output report is generated here, you can see it is saying location over here, but I don't want to say in my report this is a location. I wanted to say as a training location. Okay, and then date column. So we are selecting all 5 columns. With the first thing, we are changing the name over here in this column name. So how would you do this? You have to put as in behind your column name and new name which you wanted to provide it. Okay, so let me run this and see the output. Okay, so here you can see this is my first query output, this is my second query output. Okay, so ID, course name, course fee. Now the column name has changed over here because of alias. I have given the different name over here, and this is the date which we are selecting. Now if I don't want to select over here the course fee in the output and the date in the output, I can simply delete this and just provide the column which I want into select statement. So only ID, course name, and training location, these 3 things have been selected. So that is how you would be either put, if you want to fetch all the columns, simply put the star, don't write all the columns, because sometimes it is possible your table has 20-30 columns. You don't want to write every column name over here because you want to select everything in your report. So you would be using asterisk sign over here. Okay, but if you want to select some few columns from your table, just provide the name of the column which you want in your output. Correct. So that is how your first example we have seen the select statement work. Okay, now let's move further over here. What we would be doing here. So there are other options. You can create a new table from existing table to combine the data. Suppose I have more than one table. Okay, this is my okay, let me show you over here. This is table 1, and this is table 2, which has a this has a 3 columns, this is a 4 column. I wanted to combine both the table and generate a 7 table column. That is possible. Okay, so that is whatever name you want to give this result. That is one way of combining the tables. So that is horizontally we are combining. Correct. Similarly, you can vertically combine the table. And so suppose there are 3 rows in this table and there are 10 rows in this table. So horizontally, vertically combining this table, you can generate the 13 rows table. But there are many conditions, many factors come in between. So when we do the join and combining the operation, so we'll learn about this. Okay. So there are various operators available, like your inner join, outer join, natural join, set operators, except, union, etc. to combine the table. Okay. So now let's move further. Okay. So this is how. Calculating values within the select. So now we have seen here, this is how you can explicitly select a column from the table. Okay, this is your table name. Okay, so this is how it should be. Select whatever you want to select. As operator, if you want to rename your column, you don't want to give the same name which already in the table, so you can use the as operator over here, and from which table you want to fetch the data. Okay. Now, in the second example, what we are doing over here, now let me remove this format code over here. Okay, so in this, using the asterisk sign, we have selected everything, correct? So now this we have seen like how my data looks like, correct? So this is my data. Now using the feedback option, you can and see like my actually what query have been fired, exact query. Okay, because you don't know the column name or anything. Either you copy your column name from the result, that is one option, or you can see in the log what exactly is the query is fired. So here you can see it has fired select star from work he data one, but that is not true. Actually, before firing this query, it changed something underlined. Okay, so let me first go through one concept actually. So SAS, exactly, this is your SAS engine, correct? Let's say this is your SAS platform. This is your data stored on the disk, correct? So this is your file. So, and to fetch this data as a SQL query output, so SAS has a processor which is actually SQL processor, known as SQL processor, which runs on this table and give the data as a report to you. Okay, so that is SQL processor. So this is when your query, you submit it, actually your query would be submitted to this SQL processor, which select data from this and generate the report. So before submitting the SQL query, SAS would internally modify this query in whatever way it want to submit to the SQL processor. Okay, so now here I wanted to know what query actually SAS has submitted to the SQL processor. I would be putting feedback option over here in the proc SQL statement over here, correct? So this is how it works. So let me run over here and you can see feedback will tell you output is same, correct? But here feedback will tell you what query have been submitted. So in the log you can see this is the query have been submitted to the SQL processor. So your select star from work.he table, this he data one table query have been changed to something like that. This is, let me copy paste over here so it would be easy to understand. So what SAS did actually, it selected all the column explicitly, ID, course name, course fee, location, date, correct? And put the table name in front of each column name as well, correct? So this is way, if you, because you can select data from more than one table as well. So you, and your table has a common column name, then it needs to identify from which table it has to select the specific column. That's the reason it is putting the column name in front of the, your column name, like from which table you want this column. So we'll tell you when we do the multiple table select, then we'll do. So what exactly it is doing is like it is converting your query in this format. Okay, when you put the feedback option, you can see like actually this query has been submitted to the SQL processor, correct? So this is how it it feedback option works. It tell you, feedback option will tell you like what query have been submitted to the engine, correct? So We'll come to this, how to calculate the value. You can even rename the column in the output report. So we have seen how to rename the column in the output report, correct? Using the alias, we can rename the column. Selecting all the columns. We have done like using the asterisk, we can select all the column. Using the feedback option, you can find the columns or query which is executed by the SAS proc in the log. Feedbacks option also resolves the macro variables and places parentheses around it. This would I would discuss when we learn the macro, because I don't want to get confused too many stuff over here. So macro is different to concept altogether. So we would be discussing about that later on. Creating a column. Now, even you can create a new column while selecting the data. This new column could be only be in the output until query exists, or rename the column using the alias as we have seen here. So we will learn how to create a new column and how to calculate the values in this column. So let me go through third example, what exactly this third example has. Okay, so now here, calculating the column. Okay, so let me delete this and put the example third over here, format code here. So what exactly calculating the column? So this is the title, I just kept it. Okay, this is how you put the title in the report. So that is what. So here what I am saying, select star means every column from this table HE data 1. But one additional column you create using the calculation. So what we are doing here, whatever the course fee column is there, apply the 18% tax on that and give me a new column which contains the calculated value as well. So in the same query, you are calculating and generating this calculated column in the output. So 18% tax I am applying on this query, in this course fee. Okay, so we have seen in previously, correct, this course fee we have in this table. I wanted to apply 18% tax on this, and whatever the new value come should be come as a separate column in this table. Okay, so that is my requirement. So what I would be doing here, I would be putting star over here to select everything from this table, and plus this one additional column. So you have to use comma here to separate out each column here and give name to this new calculated column. Okay, let me remove this. Okay, we'll see what exactly. So now give me the course fee to fee which has a 18% tax applied. So let me run this query so you would better understand this. So this is my course fee 800. Once I apply 18% tax over here, so my fee become 944, correct? But this column does not have a name over here. You can see the name is not there. So nobody knows what exactly this is, correct? So this is the total fee which is 18% tax applied. So how, what I would be doing here, again, this is even calculated column. I can use the as operator over here to give the name to this column using the alias. So this is known as the alias. Okay, so this is the column name which we are adding to our data. And now you can see there the column name total fee is provided. So 18% tax applied on this course fee. So that's the reason this is 944 is my price over here. Correct. So that is what how you calculate new columns and create a new columns using the calculated value. Okay. This new column would only be in the output until your query exists. Correct. So this query exists until, because this does not modify this table. Okay, this table still contains the same data because we are not modifying the data. We are selecting data from this and additionally creating the column in my output. So if I don't run this query, still my data in this table won't be affected. Only the output would be affected. Okay, that is the point you have to remember. You can rename the column in the output report using the alias. Referring alias column. We can refer calculated alias column somewhere else in the query as well. But you have to keep in mind few stuff. Okay. And we'll discuss about this. And even using the label, you can assign the different column name to your column. In and that would label would be used in the your generated output. So let me go over here in the fourth example. Okay. What exactly here we are doing. Okay, distinct. Okay, we'll discuss about this later on. Okay, so I'll not go through the example right now because this is not. So we can refer this column, alias column, in the query as well. Okay, so if you want to remove the duplicate records, then use the distinct keyword in the select statement. Let's say in my query, okay, in my underlined table. Okay, this is my table. This has course ID 1. Name is Hadoop, location is Mumbai, same to SAS, Location is Pune. Okay, third record. Python. And location is Chennai. And again, this record. First record is repeated. And Mumbai. I don't want this record to be repeated in my output report. What I would be doing this. So I would be using distinct keyword in select statement. So it would give me only this three record, only three records. First from this and this, only one record would be selected, and in the output that would be only like this. And these are already distinct records, second and third. So that would be in the output, correct? So let's go through the example and then understand. So we have already covered three examples. So let's go here. On the fourth example, where we are doing this stuff. So here now different file here, hedata3.csv file. You have to put in different location. So you learn how to put data in different location, etc. Correct. So I'll cap every file on different location. Okay. So you need to manually go over there and put the file over there. So the same way we will be creating the table name here, hedata3. Okay. So before selecting any specific column, I just wanted to show you the entire data in the table. So what we would be using here, star, correct, remove everything else. Okay, so now let me run this portion so we can first look at the data. Okay, so my data looks like this. This is a huge table. Okay, you can see almost 180 records in this table, and this table has row number in the output. Why? Because we have used here option number. Okay, let me remove this right now. I don't want to confuse you. Okay, so now row number have been removed. ID column, this is my date, course name, course field, location and date. The data is say, well, column is same from our previous example, but the volume is higher. Correct, now 180 columns over here. Now, if I put here, order by course name, okay, so just we'll discuss this later on, but let me just show you data, like is there any duplicate record or not. So that would be easy for me to put the order by. So if you see here, this three has the same course name, but ID is different, so these are not duplicate record, correct, until and unless I select only course name over here, correct, because this course name is a duplicate over here. This is 5G, this is AI, so this AWS, this is all repeated course name, but my entire record is not repeated. Correct. So now this is how the data looks like. Now if I select the course name only from this table, correct, let me select only course name column from this table. Let me remove this part. Okay, the output. Okay, so if I select only course name, still how many records would be in the output? 180 records would be in the output, because every record has a course name in this, so all 180 records would be in the output. But this doesn't look good, correct, because I want only distinct courses which is conducted by HadoopExam.com. So which all are distinct courses are available on HadoopExam.com. So just simply you have to do this as name suggests, put distinct keyword in front of this. Okay, so then here order by is not necessary actually, so you can remove this order by. Okay, if you want it, you can order by sorting of the data. So I will discuss that later on. So I'm not keeping it over here right now. So I'll run only this portion of the query, and we can see only distinct courses. So how many distinct courses? Only 48 distinct courses are being conducted, whether it has a duplicate or not. So the order by clause would help us to find it out whether there is any duplicate record or not. So one way of identifying, because by looking visually, we can see, so there is no duplicate entry we can see over here. So this way we can find all the distinct record from the table, correct, on this particular table. Okay, so this is the my fourth example. Okay, now let's take the next example, fifth example. Okay, this is quite big, so what I'll do, I'll stop now. Actually this is a quite long session, so I have to divide into multiple parts. We would be going to cover in this module itself 16 examples. So thanks for watching, and if you are watching on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe it. We would be keep adding such sessions and to make you SAS expert as well. So keep visiting HadoopExam.com, and all the relevant link we would be providing below the in the description section of the video on the YouTube as well. So thank you. Thanks for watching, and I hope you like this session, and please don't forget to refer your friend for this such kind of material, they would get as well. Okay, so thank you. I'm stopping now.